Scorpio, welcome to your September 2021 reading. We're going to be getting an idea of which Scorpios I'm speaking with right away when I shuffle these cards. They've all been pre-shuffled. After that, if it resonates, stick with me and we'll be getting an idea of what's coming at you this month of September, and also some hidden insight, perhaps influences underneath the surface that are that are pushing things around and influencing them. If this resonates, please hit the like button. Please hit the subscribe button. It greatly helps the channel. I appreciate it so much. All right, so we're just gonna give these one last shuffle. And again, the first cards that we'll be flipping out will be determining which Scorpios among you that I am speaking with. You can't hit 100% of the people 100% of the time. So we're just getting real with it, you know? So, please, Spirit, for September 2021, which Scorpios am I speaking with? Please give us some insight. Which Scorpios am I speaking with? Flipping the deck but not flying out is the Two of Cups. And that is that companionship, that partnership card. We have High Priestess coming out with Scorpios, which am I speaking to for 2021? The Lovers. Wow. And the Four of Wands. I just want to peek at this one because it feels like the Knight of Cups. There you go. This feels very much wrapped up in your relationships. Okay, Scorpio 2021. Okay. September. Interesting. Let me take this all in. Some of you guys are going to have, this very much does seem a partnership slash home security, you know, like it's around relationship. And some of you guys are going to be coming up against a choice regarding your security. It affects your security. For a few guys with the Four of Wands, a few of you guys are going to be getting invites to gatherings, and that's where the choice is coming from. But for others, there is a choice that is more around your belief systems. You know, with Hierophant, it rules over marriage, it rules over the institutions, like school systems and churches and all that. But bottom line is commitments. And when the Hierophant flew out, it flew out with the Four of Swords. And Four of Swords is a contemplative, thinking, meditative card. It feels that you're using your, with the High Priestess coming out, that is suggesting that you're really trying to reach into your intuition. You're having faith that your gut is going to lead you forward in regards to making a decision around this relationship. Let's get some clarity here. This is September. So I'd like clarity on each one of these cards, starting with the High Priestess for our Scorpios, September 2021. High Priestess puts clarity on the High Priestess. Scorpios that we're talking to. Ah, interesting. You know, the Star card comes out when it's like being seen for who you are. It's also the Get Your Wish card. It's things lining up and almost like a healing going on. All right, for the Lovers, what's this Lovers about? You got two. You're being called to pay attention to balance regarding this choice or this relationship. There's a sense of exhaustion attached to it. Like you're not going to be giving up anytime soon, but you're tired. This is the Wounded Warrior. And it's like, it really feels like you've been keeping something up for a while. It's like you are juggling all those things in the air. And it's not like you have any plans to stop juggling, but you're just getting tired. And so with the balance, the Two of Pentacles, these aren't bad cards at all, but it's just bringing to my attention that regarding the Lovers card, which is ruled by Gemini energy, I don't invest too much into the zodiac signs attached to the cards because you eventually end up with every sign on here. But I should say that it is Gemini energy. It is oftentimes a choice or even literally the lover is a relationship. So regarding this choice slash relationship, it's been putting you kind of on the fence a little bit with your energy. And you're just, you know, you're busy and you're keeping all you're juggling all those balls in the air and you're keeping them all up in the air, but you're just tired. Four of Wands. Why are we getting Four of Wands? Yeah. Okay, Hermit. Why are we getting Four of Wands? Four of Wands. Are you getting High Priestess again? I feel like you're staying home. It's funny. I feel like even though Four of Wands is a gathering card, it's like you have this retreating energy. There's a sense of feeling of people around you, a feeling of being noticed in this reading for you Scorpios that I'm speaking to. And you're retreating, you're kind of retreating back into yourself and your gut and digging into your sense of intuition to move forward. There's a sense that you don't trust others' advice, that you really want to trust your own. This was similar almost to Libra's reading, because Libra very, very much this month was being advised to dig down deep into their belief systems and their intuition. One of their first cards was also the High Priestess. And so yours is more regarding a choice though, and regarding your sense of security, that in the security that people give you. Okay, not like, this is not a money thing. It doesn't feel like. It feels like the people around you, security and your relationship. Okay, Four of Wands or Four of Swords. There's some inner struggle about a possible new either creative endeavor or relationship coming in. It's like you can feel the world is opening up. There's this opportunity to take this offer and you haven't made a move towards it. It's just basically you are analyzing its potential and whether or not you should go forward, but there's some struggle there. This is possibly others, but very much possibly within you. What is this Five of Wands regarding? Yeah, so what you're struggling with is that there's more work involved, and so there's like almost a learning curve. There might be research. It's just getting out of your comfort zone. It's like this is the inward struggle, and potentially advice from others too, but the inward struggle that you're having with this new offer, this new opportunity, is that you realize it's going to be more work. You're kind of at the fork of the road. You're looking at all the work you've done in the past to get to this point, and you're like taking a deep breath and being like, if I do this, I'm making more work for myself. I have, fascinating. So you're definitely, but you're considering it. You're kind of going back and forth. You're wavering back and forth. It's this energy right here with the Pentacles. Like you're already tired. So it's like, do you take this opportunity and make more work for yourself? With a Hierophant, please clarity for our Scorps for the month of September, 2021. Yeah, you're getting some big messengers with a Hierophant, the judgment called, being called an awakening. There's something, I think there's a brutal truth you're willing to look at. It's your own truth. You need to be really honest with yourself, and it's about your commitments. This is very much Scorpio, about your commitments. And this is a big change, life change. Cutting something out is a very big potential, but kind of not afraid to just turn around and face what are your limitations? What are you willing to do? And you're getting major arcana through here, not the King of Swords, but, and going forward, taking the duality of the situation and moving forward. It's kind of like, there's some aspects of this, of your life right now that you don't have a choice in, and you're gonna be accepting of that. You're gonna cut out and alter the things that you can change, and you're gonna move forward. So with that being said, okay, I'm gonna open another deck and we're gonna see what's coming at you. If you're still with me, Scorpios, if this resonated, that means you're probably still sticking around. Please consider liking and subscribing to the channel. Thank you so much. All right, so just gonna clear out the deck, cleanse it, put some of your energy in there, Scorpio, for September 2021. Thank you, Spirit. One more. What's coming at Scorpio in September 2021? Please help them prepare. What can they expect? Thank you, Spirit. Okay. King of Swords again. This is getting very clear. Eight of, I would like clarity on some of them just to give you more detail. The collaborative card of, okay. September for Scorpios. You have options. You've got Four of Wands again. Yeah, so it's interesting because so now we're moving forward into September, and now there's kind of an element of what you're investing yourself into, and it does feel like it touches work, right? It's where are you putting your time and how are you investing in this? And there's very much this King of Swords that is still prevalent in September, and he's going to defend your energy and cut out whatever you don't need. And even though the Queen of Swords is really the notorious one for cutting people out, I feel that the King of Swords is just this battle-worn energy, been through it, you know enough of the game and about life to just have no bullshit. It's logical and analytical, not emotional. So you're basically getting this offer in September that you're not really going to take. And I would like a little clarity on that Four of Cups about this offer. Thank you. You're getting a lot of doubles. So you've got the Chariot card again. Okay. All right. You're having this big wake-up call. And you're going to be taking that duality of the situation, going forward with it. But then there's an offer that comes forward. And with the Knight of Wands, it's fiery, it's action-packed, it's fast-moving. This message, this could be a person, but this is basically an offer coming in that might seem alluring. It might really look good. Literally, if it's a person, the person looks good. You know what I mean? Be careful of not forcing yourself into this offer. Be really honest with how you feel when you get it. If it makes you feel exhausted, Eight of Pentacles is coming up here. Yeah, this is the end of something you were really working hard on. It's not an easy ending either. It's like it might have been controversial or it might have been rough, but I think that you're going towards, let's see, what is this Ace of Pentacles about? Wow, yeah, like you're getting two aces. You got Ace of Pentacles and with Ace of Swords. You know, this, you speeded up this ending because I think you are making way for something that is going to pay out more. And I feel like that money is going to come quicker. Like it's almost like a money drop of some sort. You know what I mean? Like, you sell a house or you inherit something. There's a message coming in as well. So I feel like this is going to allow you to, now we've got a Three of Pentacles. This is a collaborative card. This is usually being recognized for your work and paid for it and vice versa. But it can usually be coworkers. So we've got a Ten of Pentacles with a, So this is definitely going now into, you're getting all pentacles. Yeah, it's like you want to feel generous again. You want to leave being the character of the King of Swords, which you are currently, back to being Queen of Pentacles. And Queen of Pentacles energy is like very nurturing. It's generous. It's, you know, somebody who can work really hard and but be demonstrate their love by, you know, providing, you know, financially providing, but also just being really nurturing. It's a very lovely nurturing energy, and you're looking for reciprocity here from a group of people. So I feel very much throughout this whole reading that there is, or it could be a coworker or something like that. I feel very much through this reading that trust is really, your trust has been on the fringes. It's been put to the test. And so this is about getting your trust back and kind of making your way back to the Queen of Pentacles, being able to be, to enjoy that sweet, nurturing side of your nature. But you can only do that once the King has really fully done his job, the King of Swords, that is. So we've got the Seven of Cups coming up, which is always options. Be careful of all that glitters is not gold. This is the third time you've gotten the High Priestess, okay? We've used three decks, High Priestess, High Priestess, now the High Priestess, making this diagonal pattern across here. Regarding these choices, so in September, Scorpios, you're gonna be noticed, you're gonna be seen, you're gonna feel a little bit overwhelmed sometimes, you're gonna have options. And that's why you've got the King of Swords energy coming out here with no bullshit, because you need to like slice and dice out some of those options and narrow it down. We've got Four of Wands here. Why are we getting Four of Wands? The Devil. Why are we getting Four of Wands, please? The Sun. Big, big stuff. Big major arcana. Four of Wands. This is a fascinating read. Why are we getting Four of Wands? And we've got our second card, the Wounded. We're getting our second Wounded Warrior here. This looks like getting overcommitted in things. You're gonna be breaking through a cycle of feeling overcommitted, obligated to others, and you're going to be accepting of yourself for what your limitations are. And limitations can be kind of a bothersome word. Nobody likes the word limitations, but you're gonna be embracing this word in September. You're gonna be like, nope, this is what I don't have energy for, and this is what I do, and this is who I have energy for, and this is who I don't. And it's going to give you a sense, a deeper sense of security that you felt currently, that you feel like has been on the fringes. What invisible influences are at play for, you're getting a lot of information coming in. These could be text messages. There's possible travel for some of you guys. If it is travel, it'd be quick travel. So it'd be like not car, but plane or something. Leaving something behind. Mm-hmm. Getting the Star card again. Mm-hmm. Two of Wands again. We're getting, we've got the Two of Wands right here. You're putting yourself first. You're putting the things that matter, choosing. You know, not all that glitters is gold. The Seven of Cups, you've got all these options. You might have people, a lot of people around you. And that's why you're kind of retreating with a Hermit card and right into the High Priestess energy, which is running a diagonal with three High Priestesses through this entire lineup of cards. So in the invisible kind of forces at play, right? The hidden influences and all this, there was a sense of leaving something for the unknown, something for greener pastures. There was quick communication regarding this, and then we've got the Star card and the Death card. It's like this is you leaving something that you at one point put a lot of energy and really worked on building. It was really important to you, and then you just turned your back on it and was like, you know what, I'm gonna take the risk, I'm gonna start walking towards the hills. Looks like greener pastures over there. And you're doing it for your own self-preservation. And you know, there is this natural death that occurs, end of a cycle of some sort. The important thing to keep in mind, and of course, death is Scorpio energy. I got to throw that out there. But like the important thing to keep in mind with the death card, because it's not a bad card, it means it's a natural death that needed to happen. And with the death, new, it also brings in new things, new community, new opportunities. You're getting the Justice card. There might have been contracts, or whenever you can look this up, you know, whenever the Justice card comes through, it's usually it's a positive sign. If you have anything with the judicial system or contracts, that it's going to work out okay. But yeah, you've got this Justice card, this doing the sense of what's right for you, attached to the death of this, leaving something behind for the sake of yourself. And then we have a partnership coming out with the Five of Swords, a sense of being right at all costs. So this is really interesting. When I stand back from this, Scorpio, it feels very much like you're putting yourself first. You're digging deep down into your intuition to move forward with a choice. You're gonna have quite a few options in September. You're definitely bringing some things to an end in kind of a brutal way with the Ten of Swords here attached to the work card. And you've got the King of Swords guiding you, you know. You're gonna be making your way back to Queen of Pentacles energy near the end of the month. You're gonna be feeling like your old self again. You're gonna be feeling like it's safe to be generous again and to be a little more vulnerable and soft and nurturing. But for now, you are really operating from a place of deep inner strength in order to get a stronger foundation, get your sense of security going again. I would encourage you to just be aware of your energy. You're not gonna be giving up on anything necessarily. It's like you're with the Chariot card, you're gonna be plowing right through adversity. But you know, you do have the Wounded Soldier card, Wounded Warrior card coming up multiple times in this reading as well. And that just suggests that, you know, notice when you're being depleted and allow yourself to go into hermit energy and your high priestess energy to fill that well of energy back up. But this is looking really good, and it's a very deep reading. I'm not surprised for you guys, Scorpio. You guys are deep. I love you, and I will talk to you guys soon. All the best.